the relationship with your inner child. I want you to understand that your inner child is not your enemy. Your inner child is a part of you who is asking to be healed, who is screaming, who wants to get love, who wants to feel safe, who wants to receive support. And we all have inner child. No matter if you're 30, 50, or 60, or 70, we all have inner child. And the person might be successful at work, might be a great friend, but when it comes to personal life, the person is not happy. For example, a woman in her 60s cannot create a loving relationship because she believes in a fairy tale. When it comes to relationship, her inner child is coming out and she still believes in fairy tale. She believes that one day her Mr. Right, her Prince Charming, will come, sweep her from her feet, and they will live happily ever after. She does not want to accept the idea that she has to work on herself and she has to work on the relationship. Even if you look in the fairy tales, even if you look in the Disney movies, before happily after comes, there are a lot of challenges. There are a lot of obstacles that Prince Charming and the princess have to overcome. So happily ever after happens only at the end. But before, the prince has fight his fears, has to be strong, has to learn how to keep his word. A princess usually does something like Ariel. She was living, you know, under the water. And she, in order to be happy, in order to meet the prince, she had to say goodbye to her tail. She has to go through pain, through fear. So in order to find the Prince Charming, you have to work on yourself. And same for the man. If you want to be with a princess, with an amazing woman, you have to overcome your fear. You have to learn how to be responsible. You have to learn how to be brave, how to be the strong man that she will fall in love with. And a woman who is 60 and who cannot create a loving relationship, she can say something like, love should come naturally. You should not force the love. You should not force the relationship. And I'm not talking about forcing. Your partner, he should not be a psychic. He cannot read your mind and he cannot understand and accept you the way you are. This is a fairy tale. If you want him to accept you the way you are, then you have to become acceptable. You have to be that person. You have to be a princess or a Prince Charming. Then another person will fall in love with you and accept you the way you are. The biggest filter that women have called Prince Charming. And who's the Prince Charming in the real life? A man who has a car, because Prince has a horse, right? And not just like old horse, he has a white, nice horse. So the real prince in real life should have at least a nice car. Maybe not like the most expensive car, but it should be a good brand, right? Then he should have his royal land. And royal land, he might be a businessman, he might have his company, his own company, or he might have a good career. Then he becomes a Prince Charming. A Prince Charming offers his princess to become his wife. So a modern prince is a man who is not afraid of commitment, who is not afraid of exclusive relationship. Not just let hang out and see what's gonna happen next. No, this man, he wants to have a family. He wants to be serious. He wants to have a meaningful life. And at the same time, he's not gonna marry just anybody else. He wants to be with the princess. And the princess is the one who has a nice figure. She is not overweight. When she came to see him, she looked amazing. She was wearing a nice dress. She had a nice haircut. She had a nice makeup. She knows how to take care of the family, right? She, the Cinderella, she was working for years, learning how to create a nice atmosphere at home. She never complains. Cinderella is not the complaining woman. She's not a drama queen. She knows how to keep her emotions. She knows how to be in touch with herself. She was singing, she was dancing. So a woman who knows how to have fun, how to enjoy life. A woman who is not waiting for the Prince Charming to save her from all her problems. No, she's bringing joy into the relationship. This is your fairy tale in a real life. The Prince Charming is a successful businessman or successful person who has a great career, who is responsible, who is honest, who is brave. And the princess is a woman who takes care of herself, who looks great, who knows how to present herself, who is not complaining, who is bringing joy and happiness into the relationship. Then boom, this is your happily ever after. But in reality, we have inner child, and our inner child is asking to be healed. And one inner child meets another inner child, and they both expect too much from their partner. They both expect unconditional love, for unconditional support. And as a result, they cannot fulfill each other's expectations. And as a result, we have two broken hearts.